It seems like we're in a bad phase at the moment in regards to the aviation industry, with so many negative headlines appearing almost every week. And you wouldn't be wrong in assuming that the past 2 years have been pretty bad and stained the overall image of the industry. We've had numerous incidents occur with a few fatalities, we've had famous airlines go down under, and a few airlines whose destiny seems very unstable. Now, although a few headlines may be exaggerated, it doesn't take away from the fact that the industry is a brutal one, and you have to stay on your guard to protect yourself. Now, the list of potential airlines that could go down under will essentially go on forever. I don't think there's any airline that isn't facing problems in one way or another. But here are 3 airlines that are seriously in trouble and you should keep your eye out for them. Now, firstly is WOW Air. Now, WOW Air is based in Iceland and they have the great benefit of reaching most of the European and North American cities due to their location, which is something similar to Emirates and Dubai. Now, they have a fleet of 14 A321s, 3 A320s and also 3 A330s. So they offer a variety of international and also domestic flights. Now, for quite a while they've been working behind the scenes, not gaining much attention, but over the years they've gained the eyes of the world. They've also released aggressive expansion plans to grow the airline and also increase tourism in the country. However, it's not all flowers and candy for the airline. Like the European airlines that went bust, they're also feeling the pain of high fuel prices and general increase in their costs. They've cancelled most of their routes to the US due to less demand. They've also scaled back on their expansion plans as rising fuel prices have limited their ability to tap into the Asian market. On top of that, fierce competition from Norwegian and BA has also forced them to reduce their transatlantic frequency. But you might be thinking, that's just how it goes. And you're actually correct, but if we look deeper, that's where the issue lies. They're actually in heavy debt. A debt of around $50 million. Now, this has affected their operations, the salaries that they offer, and also the services that they provide. They're also planning to launch public offerings where they sell part of the company to raise money from the public to pay for their running costs and also decrease their debt. Now, they're not in the red zone at the moment, but you should keep your eye out for WOW Air. Now, next is Air Belgium. Now, the airline was launched all the way back in 2016, but they didn't fly out of anger until earlier on this year. They only operated one route, which was to Hong Kong, and their fleet of 4 A340s, 2 of them were on the ground because they weren't being used. They cancelled their only flight and they focused on wet leasing. And we all know if you do it right, then you can make a lot of money. But the fact of the matter is that they're not making money, they're actually losing money. This is due to their inefficient fleet of the A340s. Without going too deep, we know that 2 engine planes are more efficient than 4. The more fuel needed, then higher the fuel bill will be. Now, the airline is paying significantly more to operate than had they operated 2 engine aircraft. But regardless of the planes, they haven't expanded fast enough. They just seem to be stuck where they started. Now, the only reason why they're still alive is due to their wet lease agreement with BA. Once that agreement finishes, then it will be very hard for them to lease out all of their A340s due to less demand for the plane. Their future is relatively secure for now, but once the planes are returned to the airline, then it will be interesting to watch where they go from there. Now, next is the infamous Jet Airways. Now, they've also felt the pain over the last few years, so they've taken drastic measures to reduce costs, including grounding several of its wide-body fleet and encouraging staff to take unpaid leave. What's more interesting is that the grounded A330s are all leased, so the airline is paying leasing costs while making no money from the planes. But the problem actually lies with their finances. Due to rising fuel prices and the rate of their currency decreasing considerably, this has led to record losses. They've reported losses of around $318 million. Now, there have been reports that the airline was about to be sold, but that deal collapsed. There was also talk of government help, but that was never received. And there's also been talks of Boeing giving the airline money to help them in this situation. Now, around August, the airline claimed that reducing staff wages was not a cost-saving measure, rather it was a restructuring in order to accommodate a new business model. Now, despite ordering $8 billion worth of new 737 MAX 8s, they've been deferring their order for quite a while now. Etihad, who are also struggling themselves, have given an injection of around $35 million to help the struggling airline. This was done by the pre-purchase of air miles under the Jet Privilege Scheme, and again the airline assured the world that this was nothing out of the ordinary. But if we look past their talk, no matter how much the airline tries to convince anyone that everything is okay, their actions speak otherwise. If the situation over there isn't truly rectified, then we could see them fall under, as many are predicting. So all in all guys, even though it seems dramatic that airlines are going bust every day, this is pretty normal. If you look at the history of aviation, then you'll find hundreds of airlines that have gone bust over the years, as some airlines adapt and some don't due to ever-changing business environments. Now guys, the list could go on and on forever. These are the three airlines that caught my attention. If you have any opinions or thoughts regarding this list, then be sure to share them in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching guys, like and subscribe, and I'll check you very soon.